In the holy name of Jesus, amen. Our sermon is based on these words from Jesus. What I say to you, I say to everyone, watch. Watch. Those are the Lord's words, his exhortation to you, to watch. But watch for what? Watch for the time when the Lord Jesus will reveal himself in the glory on last day to judge the living and the dead. Now, he says it will happen. And he tells us it will be catastrophic, cataclysmic, calamitous. Not because of the kinds of things we see amongst us today, the evidence from the new report from our government about climate change, but to watch because Jesus will reveal himself for all to see on that day. Jesus says on that day, because of his glorious revealing as the Lord, the sun will be darkened, the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from heaven, and the powers of the heavens will be shaken. And then they will see the Son of Man coming in clouds with great power and glory. And then he will send out the angels and gather the elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of heaven. That's Jesus. That's his own words. There will be a last day. There will be judgment day. Indeed, the end of all things is coming. And whether you like to believe it or not, it will happen. Because you just heard the words of Jesus, promise it. Jesus says that his coming on the last day is near, at the very gates of the city or the door. Heaven and earth will pass away, Jesus says, but my words will not pass away. Now, does that surprise you? Do his words shock you a bit? Have you already abolished the last day from your thinking or the way that you live? Is it even on your radar screen? Is it something that you've blown off as just idle speculation? Are you snoozing? Are you snoring? Well, in Jesus' own words, you need to wake up. Start paying attention. You need to listen carefully to the words he speaks to you, even today's sermon. It's because the Lord sent me here to preach and to teach these words of his to you. I'm his ambassador to speak his word. And again, what he said is, it's time to wake up, to be alert, to be vigilant. What I say to you, I say to all, stay awake. But again, why? Because your eternal salvation or eternal damnation depends on it. Really, it does. Either heaven will be your everlasting home or hell will be. Stay awake. We better listen to Jesus again. He says, at that time, people will see the Son of Man coming in clouds with great power and glory. He will send his angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of heaven. This is not unique to Jesus. The Old Testament prophet Isaiah spoke the same way of the last day. He said, the heavens will vanish like smoke. The earth will wear out like a garment, and its inhabitant die like flies. But my salvation will last forever. My righteousness will never fail. Or Jesus' apostle, Peter, he preached it this way. The day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then the heavens will pass away with a roar, and the heavenly bodies will be burned up and dissolved, and the earth and the works that are done on it will be exposed. So Jesus, when he speaks of the last day, he quotes Isaiah, but this time Isaiah 13. The sun will be darkened and the moon will not give its light. The stars will fall from the sky and the heavenly bodies will be shaken. But it's not unique to Isaiah or Jesus or to St. Peter. Think of St. John in his Apocalypse, Revelation 1. Behold, Jesus is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who have pierced him, and all the tribes of the earth. Or, as St. Luke records, at his ascension, the angels tell the apostles, the same Jesus will come back to you in the same way you have seen him go into heaven, that is, with clouds. Jesus also tells us more about this last day. He says that he will separate the sheep from the goats, or separate believers from unbelievers. Believers, that is, his elect, his chosen, are given eternal joys of heaven, and unbelievers given the place prepared for the devil and his angels, eternal torment in hell. This time, the prophet Daniel says it this way, but at that time, your people, everyone whose name is found written in the book, will be delivered. Multitudes who sleep in the dust of the earth will awake, some to everlasting life and others to shame and everlasting contempt. In Matthew 25, Jesus says it like this. The believers his elect, the sheep, he will say, come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. And to the unbelievers, the goats, he says, depart from me, you cursed into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. You see, scriptures have a lot to say about the last day, the judgment day. And we do well to listen. And now that we've got that straight, let's get a couple other things about the last day straight, too. As you heard today in the gospel, you cannot predict when it will happen. You don't know when Jesus will reveal himself in glory on the last day to judge all people. Now, that doesn't stop many of the big shot mega preachers of America from trying to predict over and over. When anyone, and I don't care how nice they look or how often they quote the Bible or how much they say they even love Jesus, when someone tells you or predicts the last day, Jesus tells you that's evidence that they're a total fraud, an imposter, false prophet, an instrument not of Jesus but of the devil. It's better to listen to Jesus, of course. He knows what he's talking about. Check out these words. Concerning that day or that hour, no one knows, not even the angels in heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. Did you catch that? Only the Father knows that day. Jesus doesn't. He chooses not to know. The angels don't even know. And you don't either. So Jesus says, be on guard. Keep awake. For you do not know when the time will come. It is, as Jesus says, you do not know when the master of the house will come. He may come at evening, at midnight, maybe at dawn when the rooster crows, or in the morning. You don't know. But you do know this. He will come suddenly. So watch. Stay awake so that he doesn't find you sleeping. But second, another thing needs to be corrected. When the day that Jesus comes, well, that day, he will be the one sitting on the judgment seat. You won't. Jesus is the one who does the judging. You won't. Jesus is the one who will do the talking. His words are the ones that count for your salvation. Your words don't count. Your words are never better than the Lord's. Now, I know. You spent your whole life, maybe even before family and friends, putting God on trial, prosecuting him 24/7, 365 in your mind, asking God to vindicate himself to you, to prove himself to you. But that's judging God. You act like you're the judge and that your words are the ones that are divine. But I'll remind you, as Jesus says, he is Lord and you are not. He is judge and you are not. His words are divine and yours are not. But that's good news. That's good news because his words are the words that save. In his words are forgiveness, not in your words. So it's time. It's time for all of us to repent and hear the words of the Lord and take him seriously. What I say to you, I say to all, stay awake. Yes, stay awake, watch. In order to hear Judge Jesus here as he speaks to you, hear his judgment of you. After all, every Sunday is Judgment Day, ahead of time. We might call it Judgment Day in miniature. Judgment Day dress rehearsal, if you will. But not the kind of judgment you think. As Jesus, on this day, with his Good Friday wounds showing you, pronounces you a guilty sinner, totally forgiven in his word and in his sacraments. That's a judgment of good news. At the beginning of the service today, normally we hear the words pronounced by the one whom Jesus sends, "I forgive you all your sins, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit." But that's actually a remembrance of the thing you actually got to witness today when little Everly was delivered and again judged not guilty by Jesus, forgiven as his name was placed upon her forehead and upon her heart as she was washed in water by the word. Not guilty. Good news. So there was a judgment. But the judgment was, we'd say in legal language, acquittal. Let loose. Forgiven. Truly, you are forgiven. Jesus died for you. He rose for you. His sin is your sin is his, actually, and his righteousness is now yours. Stay awake, dear brothers and sisters. Don't fall asleep. Be vigilant, because there's more. Even if the sermon's going a little long, wake up. In just a few moments, Jesus, the very Jesus who will judge the living and the dead on the last day, has something to say to you. Something to say to you in the presence of angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven. Now again, it's a word of judgment. His words do and give what they say. But this judgment is my body given for you, my blood shed for you. Eat it, drink it for the forgiveness of your sins. A Lamb of God, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world, who stands in your place as your substitute. A judgment. All the judgment is upon Christ, and you are forgiven. So as you believe, you have it. And actually, all these things that the Lord has put into place for you, that you would receive his forgiveness, his acquittal, that judgment, is keeping you and making you ready for the last day. These are how he prepares you and keeps you awake, so that it won't catch you off guard. That means no matter how harsh this judgment sounds to us with the destruction of the earth and of the heavens, we don't need to fear. Actually, we've been rehearsing for it our whole life. Every Sunday, you hear the last day judge Jesus. Every Sunday, you hear his verdict. It is for you. You are forgiven. You are saved. You are his elect, his chosen. And to all this, all we can do is respond to the Lord's word of forgiveness. Maybe like Jude, we heard in the epistle. Now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you blameless before the presence of his glory with great joy, to the only God, our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to him be glory, majesty, dominion, and authority before all time and now and forever. Amen. Thanks be to Jesus in his holy name. Amen. Now may the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.